StreamerBot Explained, connecting to OBS. Today we're going to be showing you how to connect your OBS to StreamerBot using Websocket 4. Websocket 4 is currently the older version of Websocket and may become unsupported in the future, which is why we highly recommend upgrading to Websocket 5, as this is supported and up to date. To use Websocket in a version of OBS 28 or above, you will need to install Websocket 4.9 compat. There will be a link in the description for it, but it installs like any other plugin. Connecting the Websocket allows StreamerBot to interact with OBS in almost any way. This could involve showing and hiding sources, triggering filters, changing scene, or changing text in text sources. In order to connect, we need to go into OBS, then we go into Tools, then Websocket Service 4.9 Compat. If you do not see Websocket Service 4.9, then you haven't installed the plugin correctly, so close OBS and retry. If all is installed correctly though, you'll be able to open this pop-up. Firstly, make sure the server is enabled and authentication is enabled. Here is the port. As a default, it's on 4444, but this can be changed if you wish. This is where you'll type in your password. It's recommended to use a password. So for this, we're going to use the word password. Press OK. Then we're going to go into StreamerBot. We're going to go Stream Apps, then OBS. Right click and press Add. We're going to give it a name. We're going to set the version to the 4.9. We're going to make sure the port is correct. I'm going to type in our password. You can choose to enable the connect on startup and reconnect on disconnect if you wish. Press OK and then right click and press connect, and StreamerBot should be connected with 4.9. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions or need any more assistance, please feel free to reach out in Discord. Link for that is in the description. Also, you can check out some of these other videos to teach you more about Streamer.bot.